Hello and welcome to another resin video. I got some flowers when we went to the White Cliffs of Dover, which is here in England. I got some poppy flowers. This is supposed to be a poppy, but you know, I guess it just dried to a maroon color. It's still super pretty. I also found like a cool little snail shell and then another plant that honestly I think is a weed. I also stole a rock, so I was gonna use the rock in here, but honestly it's super chalky and I wasn't sure how that was gonna affect the resin and I didn't want it to turn into a white cloud, so we're not gonna use it. Also got this little purple weed that I let dry out. So all of these, I had them in my purse and then I honestly just set them out to dry for, 2 weeks maybe? So they are super dry. And we're just going to be using the same art resin that I used before, the 1-to-1 ratio. I already went ahead and mixed it so that it is fully mixed. There's no clouds or anything in there. And very little bubbles because I did mix it very slowly. That is the key with resin and air bubbles, is mix it slow. Of course, you're going to have some air bubbles. That's inevitable. But the slower you mix it and not really the more you mix it, the slower, and you want to make sure you really get it all mixed together. That way you don't have issues in the future with it. So I already did that. It's just an ounce. That's just going to be my top layer that I'm going to put the flowers in. So I always use a kitchen torch to torch out air bubbles. Now you want to be careful with this. It doesn't have to be a lot. You honestly just have to hit it super quick and it'll take out all the air bubbles. So awesome thing about this piece is when it dried, it actually shriveled up into almost a half circle, which fit perfectly in here. Like that wasn't even planned. It just dried that way. So I kind of wanted it to just kind of curve around the edge. And I took my I say ugly, but I mean, they're still cool. I took the dried poppies and just kind of laid them on the edge as well, making sure that I really pushed them down into the resin because I didn't want any air bubbles or anything trapped in there, because that's going to be the front of my piece. So I am working backwards again. So I'm just kind of piecing in my flowers, figuring out where I want them to go. But I also have to remember that that snail shell is also going to be in there. So it was a perfect shell when I found it. There was no snail in it. He was long gone. But in order for it to be fit, or in order for it to fit in here, I had to kind of cut off half of it, which sucks, but it was just way too tall for it to fit in here. Like, it would have stuck out of the mold. So I did cut it in half. Now I'm just taking a little bit of this Roth Pearl, and I've been adding this to a lot of my resin. And it just gives it that extra kind of sparkle, because with it being a pearl, it's not necessarily like a glitter or a metal flake. It's just a very, very fine sparkle to it. I love using this pearl just because it's not so heavy compared to metal flake or any type of glitter. It's just a very fine pearl. So honestly, I mixed in way too much because I've been using this with my bigger resin projects, and it just gives that like extra sparkle to the already super clear sparkly resin. And here I used way too much. I don't know what I was thinking, but it still turned out cool. I just wish I would have used less, but it still made a really cool effect in the end. But I just made sure that I got it on top of all of my flowers because I didn't want my flowers to rise or anything. I wanted to make sure they were completely covered, because the more covered in this clear resin they are, the better off I will be for my next step, which is actually adding ink. So I wanted to make sure that this first layer, they were going to be completely submerged and clear, so that when I added the ink, it didn't like sink in around the flowers and then kind of hide them, because the ink would necessarily like absorb all the flowers and you wouldn't see anything. So the more clear you have on this step, the better off you will be, just so that, you know, the colors don't cover up your flowers. The next thing I ran into an issue with here is this shell. So the shell, as you know, is like round. So it wasn't very even either. It was kind of heavier on one side, so it kept tipping over and it wouldn't just lay flat because, like I said, I am working backwards. So it was trying to like balance it on that like highest, pointiest part of the shell was being an issue because it just kept falling over. So I tried, you know, dumping out some of the resin that was in there. I was trying to like, I guess, hold it up with my popsicle sticks, but honestly, it wasn't heavy enough, and the shell just kept falling down. And this resin does set quickly, which is awesome, but I definitely wish I would have came in and checked on it again. I did end up using popsicle sticks to hold it up, and then I balanced my little pearl jar on top of it because it seriously was just tipping everywhere. And you'll kind of find that with your projects, some things just don't work right and it's a struggle. So sometimes you just kind of have to like rig it together, which is what I ended up doing because the tape did not stick to my mold at all. So yeah, I ended up trying tape and then I ended up crossing popsicle sticks and setting my little tub of pearl on top of it, and that kept it heavy enough to where the shell stayed where it was, but then I ended up having a petal kind of sink in front of that shell. But it's inevitable, I was moving it around way too much, and yeah, it ended up working in the end. It was just kind of hard to figure out how to rig it together to get that shell to stay upright. I swear, every time I do a resin project, there's new experiences that I kind of have to either learn from or learn how to deal with. Like, there's always going to be something different in each project that you're going to eventually learn from, whether it's a better way to do something, you know, this kind of messed up. You're never going to have the exact same project, and it's hard to exactly duplicate something. So every project is different in its own way. Now I am adding the coloring. Now that first layer of resin that you just saw me pour with the snail shell, I let that cure completely. I let it just completely harden, and then the next day I came back and I poured another layer of just clear resin on top. It wasn't a full ounce, I think it was like half an ounce. It was a super thin layer. So this layer that I'm working on now is the second layer and it's still wet. So I'm using just a normal resin ink. I got these off of Amazon. It's not an alcohol ink. It's like a resin colorant or something. And that white bottle was pretty much empty. So I really milked it for all that was left in it. Normally a lot more comes out at a time, but there really wasn't much in there. So I wanted it to be kind of like a blue sky slash like sea, I guess, because the cliffs are right by the ocean here. So I used a lot of blue, a lot of white, and then kind of like a green almost color because it just makes like a really pretty blue as well when it mixes. So I used those colors, and you want to be careful with these because if you use too much, it will actually like not cure in your resin. It's a weird, you have to figure it out for yourself because obviously the size of the project, what you can use won't affect it, or does affect it. I don't know the best way to explain it, but you just don't want to use too much of it because I've learned if I use too much, it doesn't fully cure and you're just left with like a weird like jelly type of resin. It just like half cures because my resin is still mixed correctly. It's just like this adds to it and it just doesn't cure all the way through. But you could put another layer of resin on top of that after it's dry and you'd be fine and you won't have that like weird like half cured resin on the back, but as long as you use a good amount of it but not too much, you'll be fine and won't have that issue. Once I get all my colors in there, I just use a toothpick and kind of lightly swirl it around. I'm not scraping on that bottom layer, I'm honestly mixing the top, so I'm not going completely down to the bottom layer of resin, if that makes any sense at all. I'm just lightly mixing the top and then I just blow on it to kind of move it around and mix it in some more without it looking so like man-made, like with the toothpick, how you can get like those like defined swirls. If you blow the resin, it kind of moves it more naturally and gives it more of a natural wave to it. Now we are at my favorite part. So I let it sit until the next day to unmold it, and I am so excited about this piece. So again, my mold keeps getting stuck on the sides and it's not everywhere, it's only every now and then it gets stuck. So I went ahead, busted that loose, kind of cut some pieces that need be, And oh my goodness, it turned out so freaking cool. Like, I'm obsessed with how it looks. You can see all of that pearl that I used was a little on the heavy side, but still, it looks super beautiful. It is a bit thicker just because of that snail shell. I had to pour it thick just so that it for sure was all covered. But I could not be happier with how this turned out. The colors of the flowers stayed completely fine. They didn't wilt or anything since they were dried out. I'm obsessed with how it turned out. It's kind of like see-through-ish in the back because those colorants aren't completely opaque, which is awesome. So if you hold it up to the sun, you can definitely see sunlight through it. But it turned out so cool. And I'm so happy that I have this piece to remember when we went to the cliffs. Like, it couldn't have come out better. And I think this is a really cool way to preserve anything that you get from places. Like, I collect rocks and random things all the time, so it's cool that I now have this kind of way to preserve things and almost display things from all the different places that I've been. So yeah, thanks for watching. If you have any questions, be sure to comment and I'll get back to you. I love getting feedback on all my projects that I do, and if you have any ideas for the future on more projects that you would like to see, let me know, and you can for sure check out my Instagram too for more pictures of this beauty. But yeah, thanks for watching, and I hope you enjoyed it. Adios!